start a new series on my channel where the premise of it is each episode, if you will be focusing on a different nerdy fan base, I guess, different topic. So for this first episode, we're going to focus on shot, but I'm wearing my Gryffindor robe, even though I'm a Ravenclaw. But for each episode, we'll be tapping, scratching, and just making sounds with different triggers that fit in that episode's theme. I think you guys know what I mean. I'm gonna start with Harry Potter. I would have preferred to start with sound assortments, or if you also love Harry Potter, I hope that you can sit back and enjoy this video. I know I'm excited to make it, so without further rambling, let's get into it. So, our first object is this diagonally sign, and my fiancé got this for me, I believe it was in the fall, but it is just a black wooden sign with diagonally engraved into it. There's so many movies that I haven't watched that I want to watch, or just shows. I'm the type of person that I kind of rewatch a lot of the things that I already love. I have a hard time trying new shows and new movies out just because I fall in love with the original stuff I love. And I'm sure there's a lot of people that are like that. Aspect. apart from being a Harry Potter fan on a, I don't know, just unrelated view on it. I just love the movies. But I know a lot of people did. It's not aggressive. I love when it's just kind of like raindrops. Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens. Harry Potter used to be my favorite. But I watched Harry Potter actually before I watched Lord of the Rings. And then as soon as I was introduced to Lord of the Rings, flavors. So, in the movies, when you would get these, all of the colors had these really bizarre flavors. So, we have earwax, earthworm, dirt, scrumptious, cinnamon, cherry, candy floss, booger, blueberry. Oh, that's the French. Wow. Black pepper. There's one that it's the packaging's covering. Green apple, marshmallow, rotten egg, sausage, lemon, soap, tutti frutti, vomit, and watermelon. The soap flavored one makes me laugh because my fiance has the weirdest taste when it comes to food. Like, I've never met anyone with such a bizarre taste, but he has soap flavored gum that he enjoys chewing. I don't understand that man at all, in the slightest. I love him, but I don't understand. Also, if he has a bowl of ice cream, he puts milk in the bowl. It's just, he's so weird. But anyways, I feel like I would like the lemon, because I love lemon flavored stuff. I don't like cinnamon. Like, I don't like overly cinnamony stuff, and I don't like cherry. But it's in this cute little palm-sized box. It's purple, with some gold stars on it. And you can see the beans peeking through. Channeling my, unintentionally channeling in my inner Hermione with my very frizzy hair today. Oh, those sounds. Sticky crinkles. I feel like that could be a trigger word. Trigger words. Sticky crinkles. I'll say the one thing that really triggered me was that butterbeer is not in here. At least from what I've looked, and I've looked several times, butterbeer is not in here, and that is so triggering. But I guess it's the unofficial Harry Potter cookbook. Oh, I got lipstick on it. But it's a beautiful... I love purple. This is one of my favorite colors. It's like a really rich... receiving fan mail or hate mail, like Hermione after she was written up in a newspaper by reporter Rita Skeeter in Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, chapter 28. Or like Harry after he gave his fateful interview in Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, chapter 26. How many different foods do you eat for breakfast every morning? One or two, maybe. A bowl of cereal, a muffin, and hot chocolate if you have the time. Pancakes and sausages if someone loves you very much, or it's a holiday. If you don't completely skip this important meal, then how about a breakfast of bacon and eggs, sausages, fried bread, fried tomatoes, fried mushrooms, skippers, black pudding, baked beans, and toast and marmalade. Oh, and don't forget the porridge with cream and treacle. What an enormous amount of food for breakfast. But that's the traditional English breakfast for you. In the 1700s, the upper classes, and later also the Victorian middle class, were served all of that and more. This heavy-duty meal is also called the full English fry-up. But today, our cousins across the ocean eat much the same things that we do, plain old cereals or a muffin and coffee in the morning. But not to worry, you die-hard Harry Potter fans can still find the traditional fry-ups in British hotels and bed and breakfast if you ever travel to England. In the Great Hall, we find a mix of traditional and modern. Some mornings find Harry eating humdrum cereal, but other mornings he enjoys toast and marmalade, porridge with treacle, kippers, sausages, or fried tomatoes. So, there's so many different, cutely named recipes in here. Pudding, Aunt Petunia, Knickerbocker, Glory. It's really cute. So years ago when my fiancé and I were doing Harry Potter and Ginny Weasley for, I think it was Halloween. I can't wait to go to Universal. My best friend and I, we probably won't this year just because of all the you-know-what going on, and, you know, I've been out of work for like a month, so just the funds probably won't be there, but next year, we're hoping to travel to Universal Studios, because she and I are really big Harry Potter fans, so, and then I'll get like an actual wand that you can buy there, but until then, I have this wand. So basically, to make this, oh, dear lord, I can't remember the name of it, but it's basically this, like, cylindrical wooden stick that is about pretty much the width and length, well, the width of a pencil, and it's obviously this long. And what you do is you take hot glue, and you just kind of keep going around it to make it thick, and then you make all these intricate designs with the little bumps and, you know, whatever it, however you want to describe it, and then you just let it dry for a few hours. I love the scratching sound of this. And then we took black, brown, and gold paint. So we painted the higher bumps brown and indents black, and then just kind of took some gold, you can see, and just did a light wash over the high points. They were really fun to make. And the cool thing too is all of them come out very differently, because you're working with glue and it's not a cookie cutter type of recipe, so you get your own little unique wand, which is really interesting. So this one kind of has two little grips. And then I have one more. This is the other one that we made. And this one just has more of a bulbous end handle, I guess. You can just kind of see. They're super fun to make, and it's cheap. It's very cheap, because all you need is the paint. Just any normal craft paint. Like acrylic. I can't remember what they're called, but the wooden rods. Hot glue, and yeah. It's just really fun. Younger, when I was closer to probably like 11 or 12, there was actually some people who thought I looked like Emma Watson, and I didn't really see it besides maybe the eyes, and it was when I was younger, and I always just kind of like shrugged it off, and now I'm like, man, I would be honored if someone compared me to Emma Watson now, because she is a gorgeous. To me, she's one of the prettiest people in Hollywood, as far as, like, celebrities and actresses. She's got a very naturally beautiful face. What which all have like five questions on them, but okay. Let's do this one. Why did Tom Riddle change his name to Lord Voldemort? There's three answers that are acceptable, so I will give you another 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So, the response on the back is because his father was a muggle and he was ashamed. But the other two answers that were acceptable were because he wanted a new identity. And because it was easier to remember. I mean, Tom Riddle's not that hard to remember if you ask me. Okay. I'll do some fake shuffling so you can get some fake shuffling sounds. Okay, let's do this one. Oh my gosh, that was a card I picked first. How did I do that? At Gringotts. A. A Ukrainian iron belly. B. A Hungarian horntail. Or C. A common Welsh green. I'll give you another 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And it is an Ukrainian iron belly. Okay, here, let's do. These also kind of have a bit of a sticky tapping to them. Such small hands. So lastly, we have these pencils. Honestly, these might have just been from the dollar store. I don't know where these were from, but they are two different designs, and they all have all four houses. So we have Ravenclaw, Gryffindor, Slytherin, and Hufflepuff. We can't ever forget about Hufflepuff. And then this one is same type of concept, four houses. We have Hufflepuff, Slytherin, Gryffindor, Ravenclaw, and then in the middle we have the Hogwarts crest. And again, I don't think I'll ever use these. These did come in a pack of eight, so there was four of each of these. So I'll probably use the other ones and just these ones leave. Because they're pretty much, I guess, the quietest trigger. And just in case you've fallen asleep, I don't want to rudely wake you up. say this because I always feel really like weird saying this, but if you did like this video, I'd really appreciate if you would give it a like. Just, I don't know, helps me out a little bit. And if you want to, I guess you could subscribe if you want. I just feel so weird saying that because I'm like, I feel cringy when I say like and subscribe. But if you like nerdy content, if you like ASMR, I don't know, it'd be really cool if we had you here to chill out with on my videos. So I'm gonna stop being so cringy. Thank you guys for watching, and I will hopefully see you in the next video.